Hi, I'm Dala, and in this video, we're going to be doing the most dangerous thing I have ever done on this channel. There's a switch up on that wall that I'm going to flip, and when I do that, it's either going to be a large electrical spark and a fire, or it's going to double the capacity of my home battery. Let's get started and find out. Okay, first up, what is double battery support? So a lot of people have been asking me, like, is it possible to use two batteries at the same time? Maybe they have an enormous need for electricity. Maybe they need like to have two 100 kilowatt Tesla batteries at the same time. So, and I thought, well, sure, it's probably possible, but I need to test this out for myself. And I initially set out to build support for using two batteries of the same type. And this is very important because the batteries need to match each other's state of health very closely. Up on my wall, I have a 30 kilowatt hour battery. And I was thinking, how can I get another 30 kilowatt hour battery? But then I remembered that EVNX has a 30 kilowatt hour battery. And for those of you who don't know what the EVNX is, it's a 1991 Nissan NX that I've converted to electric. I have a full build series available on YouTube that you can watch in case you're interested in that. This car hasn't really gotten that much attention lately, but it's fully drivable, but it's not inspected or road legal. But yeah, that's basically EVNX. In this video, I don't want to do vehicle to grid. That's going to be a separate video because the battery emulator also supports CHAdeMO. But we're not going to do double battery via CHAdeMO support in this video. We're just going to have like two identical batteries working in parallel. So what I set out to do here with the EVNX is that I have created a high voltage connection. I've set up a DC link like wired inside this house. That goes all the way out to the wall, so I can just plug these two together via some switches. And I have also made some CAN cabling run also on the wall, so that the battery emulator can intercept this other battery. Wow, there's an even bigger mess here. So to get the two CAN channels, you basically have two options. The best option is to get yourself this kit. This is the Stark CMR board. It's set to release in a few weeks, but this is more of the like luxury option. I've been testing this, but I'm also going to show you what's possible right now today. But I will be making a separate video on this later when it releases. But let's look at my setup. And that's this LilyGo, the one that you are very familiar with already, if you've seen the battery emulator. But I've used the GPIO pins to add on a second CAN channel. So the first battery plugs in here, and then the second battery plugs in here. Unfortunately, you can't have them on the same CAN channel because then the CAN IDs would collide and it would be impossible to tell them apart. So yeah, two CAN channels are required for this. I've also then created some manual switches inside EVNX so I can turn on only the battery and nothing else, because I only want the battery to stay alive. I don't want the PDM or any other module waking up inside the vehicle, because that would consume power. So think of EVNX right now more of like a battery. It's just a battery. Ignore the fact that it's actually a car. So yeah. But now we will try to actually turn this system on. Let's take a look at the wall. It's been a while since you've seen any updates here. We still have this 30 kilowatt hour Nissan Leaf battery. It's still in use. It has been for a few years. Still a bit of a temporary install. Ideally, I want to put this up on the wall, but this setup is constantly evolving, so it doesn't really make sense to make anything permanent. Up here also on the wall, you can see a Nissan Leaf PDM charger. And we're gonna see more on this also in another video, but things are happening. Other things here on the wall is that I've added fuses. There's a fuse box here. Inside here we have 25 amps solar fuses. So this will take the 5 kilowatt DC that the batteries are producing, and you can also see here that there's a second input for the other battery. So yeah, that's the wall. And now we can go look at, let's go look more at the second battery. Okay, we are getting close. So let me show you the high voltage connection that I made. So I've used a normal big like three-phase socket, and two of these pins will be used for positive and two of the pins will be used for negative. And you have to be, this is sketchy AF. I mean, you have to switch off the isolator switch before you unplug this, otherwise you can have like an electrical arc here. So it's very important that you know what you're doing here, and I don't recommend anyone to try to replicate this particular setup. But now, when I plug this in, the battery is connected to the panel that I have there. And now it's just a matter of waiting a few more minutes, and I will check the voltages and I will flip that switch. Okay, I really want to flip this switch right here. But before I do that, I need to make sure that it's safe to do so. So let's take a look at the battery emulator stats. I have it here running on this laptop. I'm accessing the web server. And here we can see the stats of the two batteries side by side, what are the values are at the moment. And the battery emulator is actually quite clever. So we can track all the individual cells of one battery and get it in a graph format. And we can also see the second battery also in graph format. So all that is very nice. But what I really want to know is the voltage. So right now, battery number one, which is in use, is sitting at 386.5 volts. And the EVNX battery is at 385 volts. So what I need to do is to wait until the batteries are matching in voltage, and then I can flip the switch. Also here, there's an indication, red, that it's not allowing for contactor closing. So if this would have been a CAN-controlled battery, where you would have like CAN communication turning it on and off, it would be automatic when the voltages match. But since this battery right here is not CAN-controlled, I will just flip that big main breaker once it's ready to go. So now we'll spend some time and wait until it equalizes, and let's continue. Okay, we are really close. The house is not consuming a lot of power, and I want to do this. I want to connect them both when there is no load on the system, because you might know that when you put load on a system, voltage sags, and when you remove load, it jumps straight back up. So I'm using this 3 kilowatt just hot air blower to try to speed up this process and get it a bit below, and then when I release the trigger I will check that the unloaded voltage is around where it should be. So yeah, I will do that. It is time. I'm super shaky. I'm really nervous about this. I don't know why. I don't know why I'm so nervous, but I think it's gonna be fine, and then I will just forget that I was heavily nervous about this. But okay, voltages, laptop down here says that all the voltages look good, they are the same, exactly the same voltage on both batteries. There's only a 500 watt load on the battery that's connected to the grid. Okay, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna turn this switch. I have the fire extinguisher here, and I know I have fuses and everything, and it should be fine, but oh, you never know. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, nothing caught on fire. Let's check the laptop. Oh, this is interesting. So it looks like the second battery has taken up all of the load. There's a around, yeah, it has taken all the load. And the other battery is sitting at a bit higher voltage. This can be due to the fact that EVNX battery is a bit more degraded than the other battery. So it will have higher internal resistance compared to the other battery. So this will be interesting. But at least nothing has blown up, and we are taking load with the new battery. So yeah, I would call this a success. I will Now turn back the solar panels and we will try charging both batteries at the same time. Whew. Okay, I can relax now. Okay, maybe the 5X extinguisher was a bit over the top. I'm glad we didn't need this one. But yeah, the system is back up and running. I've hooked up the solar panels, so now they are charging from the sun, both of these batteries. And if we look at the application, we can see here that, yeah, both batteries, or it will just show up as one big battery, but it's charging all right from the grid. So that's really nice. What this means now is that the batteries will last way longer because they're under much less pressure. Like the load is split evenly between the two. And to make this even safer, it would be good to use like Tesla batteries or something that has CAN-controlled contactors. That way you can automate this closing of the secondary battery a bit more gracefully than having to manually flip a switch. But I'm sure, like, keep in mind, this is just the first prototype version of this. Many will probably experiment with this and make better solutions. Like, this is just a starting point. This is fully open source software. There's a link down in the description if you want to check out the Battery Emulator project itself. And when you're watching this video, the version will be out that has this double battery support. So if you have, for say, two Tesla batteries, you can like chain together two 100 kilowatt batteries to make one gigantic 200 kilowatt hour battery. So this really opens up a whole lot of doors for energy independence. And I hope you enjoyed watching this development update video on the Battery Emulator. And if you want to support these types of projects, be sure to subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for more. Like I mentioned, here on the wall, I have this PDM, this charger. We will be looking more on how to integrate that also, like for emergency charging. And also, I mentioned in the video that CHAdeMO support is coming also. So we'll be looking at how to use your EV instead of using stationary packs in conjunction with our solar panel inverter. So yeah, that's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.